Hello there, my name is Lydia, and today, as I promised, I'm here to show you how to crochet. Basically, I have some items like crochet needles, I have the yarn, crochet hooks, they come in different sizes, as you can see. Basically, the yarn is always the label is always written the size of the hook that you can use right here. Almost all the yarns have the size of the hook written, so don't worry about that. Basically, today I'm going to teach you just basics on crocheting. So this is my yarn, let it go there, down on the floor. My working space is not very big, so first I'm going to show you how to make the loop where we are going to start from. So basically this is the end and this is the yarn. So okay, this is the end and this is the continuous yarn. So you take the end, you place it right over like this, like that, then hold this end, then this loop you just flip it over the other side of the yarn, then you just pull it through like that. And there we have the loop. So we're going to start right there. So to start with, let's start by showing you how to do a chains. Basically, we always start with chains. So to do a chain, maybe we do a chain of 10. You just flip over or you wrap your crochet needle with the yarn like that from the front of the yarn, like this, not like this, like this. Just pull the loop and pass just through the other loop. So that is the first chain. Again, just like that. Two, again, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 10. So that's basically how the chains look like, just like a V. Okay, so the next thing you're going to learn, and please make practice of this so that we can go together or we can continue with the other project together. So now the next step, I'm going to teach you how to do the single crochet. You just skip the first chain because it's quite hard to work on this chain. It's quite a very near to the crochet needle. So you start with the second chain here. So get in the chain, the chain space, this one, the second one there, pull a loop, wrap like this, and pull a loop through the two. Again, don't wrap fast, so you just get in the chain space, pull a loop, wrap around, pull through the two. Get in the chain space, pull a loop, wrap around, pull a loop, or through the two. That's basically how we do single crochet. Yeah. is basically how you do it. Actually, it's becoming dark. I don't want to become dark before I finish this. So you just pull a loop, put in the chain space, pull a loop, you have two loops, wrap again, pull through the two all together until you get to the end. That's it. Chain one, just so that I can I'm able to turn my work around. So after learning how to do the single crochet, we're going to do a half double crochet. We first do it. You wrap your yarn around the crochet hook like this, then the chain space, you can see there, this one here is a chain space. You get through it like that with your crochet hook, you pull a loop, then wrap around again and pull a loop through all the three. That's a half double crochet. Again, wrap around, go through the next, now the next chain space, pull a loop, wrap again, pull a loop through all the three. Again, wrap around the next chain space, pull a loop, then wrap around again, pull a loop through all the three. Do this until the end. And please, I remind you again, practice it makes perfect. Let me pull some more yarn, please. It makes perfect. Okay. The next one we're going to do is double crochet. That was the half double crochet. Now we do double crochet. So let's chain one. We turn our work around. So for the double crochet, you wrap around just like we did for half double crochet. You wrap around, you get into the chain space, this one there, pull a loop, but this time it's a double crochet, so you wrap around, pull through the first two, then pull through the next two. Again, let's do it again, wrap around, so you have one, two, two loops on your crochet hook, then go through now the next chain stitch here, the next one here, then pull a loop, so you have three loops on the crochet hook, then wrap, pull through the first two, so you remain with two, then wrap again, pull through the last two. Now that's a double crochet. Wrap in the next chain space, pull a loop, pull a loop through the first two loops, wrap again, pull through the last two, wrap again to chain space, pull a loop the next two. Basically, that's what you need to know about double crochet. The next one I'm going to teach you will be treble crochet. For the treble crochet, okay, chain one. so that, or two, so that I'm able to turn around my work. Okay, the next one will be treble crochet. Treble crochet, you wrap around twice, one and two. Summer is here, mosquitoes are here. For the treble crochet, you wrap around two times, one, two. You get in the chain space, pull a loop. So you have one, two, three, four. So you wrap again, pull through the first two, wrap again, pull through the second two, wrap again, pull through the last two. That is a triple crochet. Again, wrap around two times like that. Okay, get in the chain space, pull a loop, then wrap around, pull a loop through the first two, then wrap again, pull a loop through the second two, then wrap again, pull a loop through the last two. Again, wrap around two times, pull a loop through the first two like that, wrap around again, pull the loop through the second two, again wrap around, pull the loop through the third two. That's basically what you need to know about treble crochet. Pull a loop, the first two, pull a loop, the second two, I pull a loop, the last two. Okay, now I want to show you the slip stitch. That is the last stitch you're going to learn today. Slip stitch, basically, you go through the chain space here, like that. You pull a loop, then you pull through also the last loop you had. Again, you go through the chain hole here, the chain space, pull a loop, then pull a loop again to the last loop you had. So that is basically, that is all I had for today. Sorry, I've made two videos because the technology also has a problem, but next time I'll make it better. So please keep practicing, and actually the slip stitch is for joining together the projects. So next time I'll show you in a better way how to do the slip stitch when we start doing projects. But for now, that's all. Bye bye and good night to all of you.